program, deliberate program, of engaging the younger people in the institutions of learning, because as we all know that the youth in this country are the majority, they constitute about 70%, and they have an integral part to play in the democratic processes of this country by participating in elections either as voters or even as candidates, because those who are 18 years and above are permitted under the law to contest for any position, either presidential, parliamentary, local government, and so on and so forth. So we feel that as the Electoral Commission, we need to engage with our youth, because we realize if they are not guided, if they are not counseled or questioned, they can be led into wrong practices, wrong activities, as we have been seeing, particularly in the areas of violence during elections. They are used by some self-seekers as foot soldiers for wrong things, either to engage in violent acts, cause chaos and commotion at during campaigns, disrupting and destroying the campaign posters of other candidates. So we're appealing to the youth that they are better than what some people would like them to be portrayed as. They have a bright future in this country. They have a stake in this country. They are citizens in this country. Even at their age, they can contribute meaningfully to the democratic processes of this country by engaging in electoral activities in a lawful manner. They raise pertinent questions concerning violence. And we are saying violence is perpetrated by the people. It's not perpetrated by extras, by people from Mars or any other entity. It is we, the people. So the best way to stamp out violence from our elections by sensitizing the people, particularly the young people. If they can, the young people can say no to whoever wants to use them in those chaotic scenes and episodes, then we shall have no more violence in our country. Second, they ask the issues about bribery. Indeed, bribery has become of great concern. Bribery of voters, corruption in elections has also taken center stage. We must deal with it. We must eliminate it. And we are the people to start doing that. But some of the candidates say it's the voters who put them under pressure to give them money, to give them all these other goodies. That is wrong. You, the voter, putting a candidate at pressure to give you money in order to vote for him or her, then you are totally missing the whole essence of democracy. You are totally missing the value of the power of your vote. You are misusing it. You are putting it on a market stall for sale. That should not happen. Therefore, I'm glad the youth are raising these issues. They have noticed them. These are our children. They have noticed the incidences of bribery in our elections and violence. And we think that by discussing these issues with the youth, we are addressing the right groups, because they are the people who are going to be the future leaders, the future candidates in the coming elections. So at the early stage, if we can instill into them these values of having proper democratic processes, devoid of bribery, devoid of violence, and so on, then this country is heading to a country, our electoral processes are heading to better and better time.
It comprised of content such as reviving the presidential term limits, two, withdrawing UPDF representation from parliament and any other partisan institutions, and also making the vice president a running mate to the president during elections. So my take on this is that we need to reinstate that bill so that we can promote democracy in our country. You know, having partisan institutions is something that is very undemocratic. So the people of this country deserve democracy in a way that we need to promote democracy in all forms. We need to revive the presidential term limits. We need to have competency in leadership. And that is why we strongly advocate that we must reinstate the 2019 Electoral Reforms Bill. We talked about the 20 million shillings. There are many people who are competent enough for this leadership, but they are really limited as a result of the money. So it is a form of commercialization of politics to some extent. So one thing I would really wish the government of this country to do is to make sure that at least we can have better or quite a number of reforms that are going to promote democracy in this country. One is at least reducing the amount of money. That is one of the requirements for the presidential race. There are very many people who are competent, and this is really not being done in a way that they are being limited by the different requirements for the presidential race. So we really need to revive the electoral reform Bill 2019 so that we can have democracy in our country. And
on your leader, whereby someone is an MP, but it was because of the influence of the parents. Let's say there is a background force. But themselves, if they don't have ideas, I think some things are also to be put in consideration. You are allowing us to contest, but you don't have money. Only those who have money are the ones allowed. Again, find out that someone comes as a background force, just sits in the parliament, they change the constitution the way they want, they don't complain. They are just there.
For the last few months, politicians and political analysis were requesting for new reports about the coming 2026 general election. But the Electoral Commission told them that there's limited time to make up the new reforms. What is your point of view?
The current government has faced legal challenges pertaining to the matters of the elimination of the age limit bill. So my question is, does the Electoral Commission have any say over the matter? And since the government has also faced legal challenges pertaining the matter of the academic qualifications of the leaders, does the Electoral Commission have any say over, or does it have the power to suggest any adjustments to the political roadmaps in matters of academic qualifications?
Recently, we are advised to register as a youth. When we register for national IDs, which are required for elections, sometimes when teachers time to go and pick them, we are asked to pay some amount of money before we get. And when that time reaches of elections, we are required to present those details so that we can also vote our person whom we feel is outstanding. So I'd like to understand whether it is amended in law that when you're going to pick your national ID, you're supposed to pay something before you get it. Thank you so much.
Yes. Wait.